felt unsteady on your feet. Okay, awesome. Anything else you felt?
I needed assistance.
You felt like you needed assistance, okay? What? You felt like you were wearing a diaper, okay? Okay, so then you could say, all right, now what I want you to do is I want you to walk around the room as if you're in a great hurry to get somewhere. You are your age, but you're in a hurry.
If you see somebody along the way, make eye contact, nod in their direction, but do not speak to them.
Okay, freeze. Awesome. That's awkward. And then you can also say, like, you can use the military term at ease, which, you know, you can just say, okay, kind of stand here and understand. And you just, once again, would ask them to reflect. How is that different than when you were old? How is that different than when you were walking just as I was examining the space? What did you feel?
Felt full of life.
You felt full of life? Okay.
Rushed.
You felt rushed. Panicked.
I felt excited.
You felt excited?
There's other ways that you can do this too, by including textures. So like if you were to say, walk as if the floor has been turned ice. Or walk as if that you're wearing ballet shoes. Walk as if your
legs feel chapped, like if your legs are rubbing against you wrong.
I'm gonna start a fire.
there's lots of ways to do this one, and there's lots of potential. This was my least favorite game when I was there, because I was like, this is kind of dumb, we're just walking around a room. We're walking around a circle. I don't get it. I don't understand why this is like, I mean, I get that we're like moving. I get it. But it's my favorite one in the classroom. And here's why. So much potential. So much potential for both reading and writing. Because when you're walking around and you're adapting these different spaces, these different things, that's physicality. And then when you look at a text and you find those clues, right, you can use them to make an inference. Right? If you're reading a paragraph and it talks about somebody walking that's kind of hunched over, moving quite slowly, right? All of those things, right? And you've done this and we've had this spacewalk, or I had you do it right now, right? What would you tell me when you were done? If I said, okay, move kind of hunched over. Kind of hunched over, just walk. Come at a slow pace. How old do you feel? Old, right? So you can lead them through an inference exercise, but also for adding detail to your writing, right? For adding those physical details to your writing, often kids, that's what they overlook, is they'll say what the person looks like, but they don't necessarily talk about the way that they move or traits, right? Those are things that they miss. Those tends to be the things that they miss, is those inferencing things that they tend to miss in reading passages, right? Someone moving quickly with purpose, making eye contact, really going for it. Good way to talk about inference. So, a way to talk about inference, a way to talk about reading skills, a way to talk about including detail in your writing.
And you can also have, like, you stop, you say, okay, turn to the person next to you and start a conversation as if you've never met. You know, there's other things you can do within this, okay? And that's what that was the next thing that we did, I think, was stop and talk.
Stop and talk, stop and, like, keep your physical pose. And start talking what comes naturally to you based on what you're doing.
So if you're old, you're probably going to say, oh my gosh, my knees are going out. Okay, if you're in a hurry, you're going to say to these, you're going to notice that the way that you speak is different. I'm in a hurry, I really got to get there. I don't have time to talk to you right now. I have got to get this and this and this and this and this done. And you notice that panicked sound and all those kind of things. So,
also a good one for teaching social cues to friends. Right? If someone's walking by currently, they're making eye contact, they're really not interested in talking to you, what are they going to do? Turn away. Right? That's a social cue that I'm not interested in talking to you. Right? So you can do it like as a kind of an affective kind of social cue, community building kind of thing, or you can do it as a classroom kind of deal. Also, one thing I didn't mention was swoosh. You can have the kids make up those activities, like the boing or whatever. So you can have it set in the setting of your book. It doesn't have to be a skate park. Maybe it's,
For science, like, you could do, like, one could be, like, a hill, one could be a volcano. So the volcano is going to be, and they have to go over to you. You know what I'm saying? I kept trying to think of science things, but I'm not that bright when it comes to science, so I tend to like.
I feel like there's some opportunities there for some things.
Across, besides reading and writing, I mean, like outside of the content area where you can do a lot of things. And this too, you know, talk like yourself, you know,
For math, you can do inverse operations, like inverse, you can go forward and then do